fans. Welcome to Gun of the Great ASMR. Thank you for joining me. I sure appreciate it. Donning my rubber gloves. Today, I will be polishing some silver I picked up at a local thrift shop. Out of shape. Not bad at all. It says Gottinger on the bottom. Like I said, use Tardex. It's good for diamonds, gold, copper, platinum, silver plate, and sterling silver. As always, when you're using something that is caustic, wear your rubber gloves, keep your pets or your children away, work in a well-ventilated area. Okay, let's get started. First off, on there. If you're pregnant, be careful using this material. Even if you're not, please be careful. One of the most favorite tools of anybody who does arts and crafts or cleans, or does restoration work, is a toothbrush. Nice soft bristles won't damage this. Look at how shiny it's already getting. Soapy water, so I get all of the Tardex off. Already nice and shiny on the top. The tarnish isn't too bad. But it can always be better. Were very popular. My grandparents had quite a bit of it. To help one of my grandmothers polish. And back then it definitely wasn't this easy. Life has gotten a lot easier over the decades compared to when my grandparents were young. But it's also gotten more difficult in many ways. I often wonder, what would my grandparents think of the world today? Personally, I think they'd be in shock with the way some people treat others and the way people speak. And often some horrible dishonesties. I would love to see integrity make a comeback. Integrity and kindness. Love. We're all on the planet together, right? Okay, I don't want to bring you down. That's enough of that. What would you like to talk about today? I'm really looking forward to cherry season. I'm in the Pacific Northwest, Washington State. We have a lot of cherry growers. Oh, I love the black cherries. Those are so good when they're fresh. Oh my goodness. Definitely looking forward to that. Yummy. Won't be long before we have cherry blossoms and apple blossoms. My neighbors have a lot of fruit trees. And they smell good. We grow tomatoes, just enough for sandwiches and salads. A lot of catnip. It's a perennial, so it comes up each year. It's out around the fish pond. Our cats, we call them catnip farmers. They're good little farmers, although they eat a lot of their own product. It's coming up really well right now. Actually wild catnip. It grows wild in our county. And I had some dried flowers with a lot of the seeds, and I let the cats play with it around the pond on purpose. And the catnip started coming up. It grows about 3 feet tall. In the fall, we harvest it and dry it. I should have taken some video the other day. My flame point kitten. He's a big boy. He's over 13 pounds, not quite a year old. I had a paper bag of catnip sitting out. Knocked it off the table, and he was lying on the floor, covered in it, rolling all over and eating it up. It was adorable. Couldn't get mad at him. He knows what catnip's for. We have a Siamese cat that she's our main catnip farmer. She's always out there rolling in it, eating it. dogs are happy. Okay. Decided yet what my next project's going to be. I just drag out my paints, my acrylics, start painting some rocks. Rock painting is quite popular in our community. People hide them, trade them, or just leave them out for people to get at the park or grocery stores. There are some very, very, very talented artists around here. I wish I had just a portion of their talent. It's impressive. Looks like there used to be some felt covering this. I'll have to replace it. These were a really good thrift shop find. There we go. Of course, I splattered all over that, didn't I? I don't know if you can hear it. My big boy is snoring. Silly boy. He's sleeping hard. They did a lot of playing already today. It was a pretty easy project. What do you think? better. Much better. Anyway, thank you for joining me. Please leave a like, subscribe, feel free to comment. As always, please take care of yourself. Okie dokie. Thank you. Bye.